and I've been ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these eyes ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only when it gets exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only when it gets exception on my crew. Yeah. Ain't no dub, ain't no L.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Can I hit that?
To the Pacific Northwest, the home of the 12s, and they are in full roar as you get a look inside Lumen Field in Seattle. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Seattle Seahawks. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. For the first time with Miles Sanders. He's at the 50, the 30, 10, touchdown, Philadelphia.
Sanders, the ball carrier.
Miles Sanders, 75 yards, and the Eagles have taken the early lead. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
They're coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Throwing is Wilson. Flushed out right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And got his man complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. They'll get 34 yards there.
43-yard line.
The gun. Here's Wilson. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Yards remain for second down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
Yeah, the Seahawks and Eagles, you might remember, they met up in the wild card round a season ago. It's a night Philly fans could probably stand to forget. Carson Wentz exited early after just four passes thrown, and Josh McCown at 40 years of age brought in. But the Seahawks, they were too tough as they slugged out a 17-9 victory. On third and one, Wilson under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
Whenever you see a team deciding to throw the ball on third and one, as a defensive player, my mindset is we've got them now, and that's why they dialed up the blitz and got after them.
But occasionally, you want to pass it on third and one. I mean, not a lot, for sure, but sometimes just to keep the defense guessing.
Oh, no doubt. You want to break tendencies as you go along with the game because you don't want them to just say, oh, third and one, we know exactly what they're going to do. But in this situation, as an offensive lineman, as a running back, I'd want to know why I didn't get the football.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Seahawks go for it but can't convert. And the Eagles defense able to hold.
It's a turnover on downs.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now a carry for Sanders. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Hurts. And he fires one, but incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
This is taken at the 10. 43-yard punt, but they get nine back on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Wilson now to throw on third down. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Well, they've moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to, again, amount to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. And now on fourth and one, it's a fake. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool this defense. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. On first and 10, it's Hurts.
Eluding the pressure right.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football. He's taken down. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He's trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts.
Escaping the pressure right.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Alden Smith in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. So on comes the Eagle kicker, Jake Elliott, on fourth down. It'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is. These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt them later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. They trail here early in this division round game as they seek a spot in the NFC title bout. On first down, they look downfield, and it's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Give him 32 on the play.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
From the gun, it's Wilson. This will be caught inside the 10. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as a wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And no return here from Westbrook. This will be a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
7-7.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
3-yard line.
From the gun, it's Hurts. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jamal Adams. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
third.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
After the interception, here's Wilson. And this one is incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And now it's second down.
Well, defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and trying not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, Wilson. He goes right back to Metcalf, this time complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. 27 yards there, a first down.
First and 10 at the 10-yard line.
They run it with Carson. And a nice pickup there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he tries to power forward, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Third down, Wilson, flushed out right. Fourth down now looming after Philly's defense stands tall in coverage.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
A 23-yard attempt.
Myers' kick is good. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Throwing is Hurts. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
The Eagles on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third down and 12. Hurts sets up to throw it. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Fielded just inside the 30. A nice Nice work on the return as he gets about 15 yards back. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Throwing again on second down. Wilson, he'll find Metcalf. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A first down there on a pickup of 25. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. From the gun, Wilson. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. That catch good for only a couple.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Now it's Carson. And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagle 16. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's Carson. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6.
Operating from the gun. Wilson. That's complete into the hands of Carson. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. This is caught, and the Seahawks are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. It's a gain of 6 as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Get this back to the 4, but that's about all.
The ball carrier.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up 2nd and goal.
No gain on the play.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, 2nd and goal. From the gun, Wilson, flush to his right. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff. Third and goal.
Operating from the gun, Wilson.
And this will be caught by Metcalf for a Seahawk touchdown.
Russell Wilson with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
The extra point now coming from Myers. It's good to make it 17-7.
It is good. Makes the score Seahawks 17, Eagles 7. Michael Dixon.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no return here from Westbrook. This will be a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Second down, here's Hurts. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. The last catch took him 2 yards in the wrong direction, so now what can they do on third?
Here's Hurts to throw.
And he's got his man on the out route. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. His first catch of the divisional round goes for a first down. He had 5 catches last week in their wild card win.
Right.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Touchdown.
A big play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are back within a score. Elliott on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game.
Makes the score Seahawks 17, come on, let's go. Eagles 14.
Jake, so not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson, three touchdown passes now. And the Seahawks add on to their lead.
Myers for the extra point.
Man, we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, give that water break and get on out there and play.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discussion.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A big play there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Escaping the pressure right. And find Everett there, complete. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. They'll come up now on second and a yard. From the gun, Wilson looking for his running back, and he's got him. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
The last catch took him 2 yards in the wrong direction, so now what can they do on third? Operating from the gun, Wilson. He's got Lockett, and he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Wilson to Lockett there for the Seahawks first down.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. To throw again is Wilson. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
10 more yards.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Most of the damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Right back to him on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He'll find Ballore out of the backfield. Not much there, only a yard.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it, but he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put there.
Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. That one goes for 30 yards. He had one touchdown earlier, nearly a second one there.
Yeah, it took a touchdown-saving tackle to keep him out of the end zone after a big play. Perhaps you go right back to him. Don't need the distance, but maybe he can pay things off after a big effort.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and goal.
At the Eagles' 6-yard line.
From the shotgun, Wilson. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Russell Wilson now with 4 touchdown passes on the afternoon. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Over the middle, taken in, and down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
Eagle first down.
Mike 56 right now.
He'll look to throw.
He'll fire it deep for Rager.
And it's intercepted. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
Now he'll let it go on the run, deep left side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The 2017 All-Pro Darius Slay there in coverage, knocking it away.
Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup.
To throw again, Wilson. Looking left side and it's complete. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
15 yards on the play, first down.
And he's certainly been a huge factor in this when he's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now.
And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
He was covered by Richard Sherman.
We sit in quarter number three out in Seattle, a second and 10 now.
Throwing again, Wilson lets it go for Nelson, and that's caught inside the 30. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. It's a big play there for Seattle. 57 yards.
At the 9-yard line.
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game.
This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. They run again with Carson, and this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked out before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. From the gun, Wilson. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
It's fourth and goal.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Myers able to knock it through. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So they settle for just the 3. But clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt. Obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off. But it still ate up time. Got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Set now to kick this one away. And off it goes.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no return here from Westbrook. This will be a touchback.
25-yard line.
Put it on me,
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. And they need to come up with something as they get this drive started.
It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Touchdown.
Miles Sanders with his second touchdown of the night. There the Eagles are back within a score. So that's a really big play here in the fourth quarter. And don't look now, they're right back in this game.
Did it feel to you as it did to me that maybe they were a little bit soft in what they were lining up with on defense? Almost like they were protecting the lead rather than trying to make a play.
And now that lead is down to just one score.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And this has been a tight game to this point. Of course, they usually are at this juncture of the playoffs. But with the lead in the football, the clock right now, their friend, as they try to book their spot in the conference championship next Sunday.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. 54 is Mike. Check, watch 54. To throw again. Wilson. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
43-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Wilson firing quickly here, and that's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Complete to number 17. A 7-yard pickup brings up second and 3 at the 50-yard line.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play, second and 3. From midfield now, here's Wilson. Out left, he's got it to Everett. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And taking it to the 15-yard line before it's brought down. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First and 10 at the 15-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one.
Third and one.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. On third down, it's Carson.
He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one. A five-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal. Try and take him home, and he will score. Touchdown Seattle, taking it in from a yard out, and the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. So now a two-point conversion attempt coming for Wilson and the Seahawks. It'll be Carson. They run for it, and they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offense has spent a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Hurts fumbles it.
We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover it.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure at him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. As he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter.
At the 42-yard line.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. On first down, Hurts. Sanders has it over the middle. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. From the gun, it's Hurts. Going for it all. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
The second down pass, intercepted. The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Seahawks in victory formation as they go ahead and take the knee.
tonight's final score.
And Charles, if you're the coach of the losing team, even though you made it to the playoffs and there's part of that that feels good, what do you say to your guys after?
I think you probably tell them how proud you are of them to make the effort to get to this game and then point them towards the future. If we're good enough to get here, all we've got to do is work harder, be better, and we can be good enough to go farther next season. How many times have we seen a team lose in the playoffs, and that girds them for a championship run in the future?
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.